Hi Virgo, this is going to be your soulmate reading for the dates of December 9th to January 9th, or basically, December to January. We're going to look at the soulmate energy for you, surrounding you, energy from your person. You'll know who your person is. We'll try to name signs, but the main thing is getting your storyline and figure out your message, okay? I'm also going to be using my Black Moon Astrology card, so we're going to be looking at the synastry between you and your person. What is synastry? I just did a video on synastry, but essentially synastry is the compatibility between you and a person's natal chart, okay? It's basically when you put two charts together and you see where the compatibilities, weaknesses, strengths, all those great things are, okay? If you're interested in actual synastry reading where I use you and your person's chart and put it together, that is available by emailing me, or if you want a personal chart reading for yourself, make sure you email me at 13 Signs Tarot. And I will get back to you as soon as I can on that, okay? Also, let's see. What else did I want to say? Oh, yeah. I do love predictions on Mondays, okay, at 10:30 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. So if you're interested in one of those are paid love readings. You can get one live. You want to pay through PayPal or Cash App, 13 Signs Tarot at Gmail for the PayPal. And $13 is love for my Cash App. On Instagram, I do free readings on Thursday at 10:30 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. So if you're interested in that, you can follow me on Instagram. I also do reading specials over there, and I post every day on Instagram, okay? YouTube, I don't post as much, but on Instagram, I post every day, okay? So let's see what's going on for Virgo and their person, please. Virgo and their person. Virgo and their peoples. What's going on for Virgos? I actually just put up a Virgo joke on my Instagram today. You guys will like it. It's really cute. My mom loved it. She's a August Virgo. Okay. All right. I wanted to flip. All right. There also will be an extended reading for this. So if you want to get the extended, where we go over your outcome for you and this person throughout December to January, so you guys can, you know, kind of see what to expect for the new year, you can check that out in the link below, okay? The extended will be there. It looks like you guys have two outcome cards, so your extended will be nice and juicy. We also have clarifying cards down here. We'll go over in the extended. You guys see your cards are already out clarified, so your extended will be ready to go. I'll do right after I do this one, okay? So let's see what we have. Your person's thoughts. The Empress. Oh, so you could be dealing with a Taurus, Libra, could be Aries or Leo energy, but this person feels that you are the Empress. They feel that you're the one. The Empress is always top for me, okay? So they feel that you are their top. They could feel a very divine and nurturing energy about you. They feel like you're on the top of your game, Virgo, like you got it together. You guys could have like strong Venus placements in your charts together. For instance, you could have your Venus is conjunct their Venus, their Sun is conjunct. And what do I mean by conjunct is sitting together? So basically their Sun and Venus energy in your chart, okay? Or there can be Venus energy in your chart, which if you're dealing with a man is really good, because Venus in his chart represents the type of woman that he is attracted to. So he feels that this person, if it's a male or a female, doesn't matter, they feel that you're very attractive. They feel like you're the top person, okay? They feel like you're on top of your game. The Empress is also someone who's doing pretty well financially. Even if you feel like you're not, they feel like you have it together, okay? So what they're feeling towards you is the Queen of Wands. So you could be dealing with a fire sign, an Aries, Leo, or Sag, just as Leo in this deck. They feel that you're very attractive, again, just like the Empress, okay? I always associate the Queen of Wands energy with the Empress. I always feel like the Empress is kind of the Queen of Pentacles and the Queen of Wands mixed together, but she's actually all the queens. But I always feel like it's that type of energy. So this person is very attracted to you, okay? Very, very attracted to you. That's very clear to me. External to them is the Chariot, okay? So we have two major arcanas. We have the Empress and the Chariot here. Could be dealing with the Cancerian energy. This person wants to make a move, okay? We have King of Swords at the bottom of the deck. Could be a Gemini, Libra, Aquarius. Wow, Five of Pentacles coming at the bottom of the deck and the Five of Cups. So we have someone who has regrets, okay? This person has regrets about the way that they treated you. They didn't tell you that you were top to them. They didn't tell you the truth. They didn't tell you that you were everything to them, okay? So they have some regrets. They want to come in from out of the cold. This is someone that you cut off. Five of Pentacles in the reverse tells me this person wants to get from being cut off. They want to come back from being cut off. So it could be a Libra. But they want to come back right. They want to tell you what's up. They want to be very clear to you with the Six of Wands. They want to win you back. And they want to establish a relationship with you, actually work on building a connection with you. They don't want any more of this Four of Cups energy, which is stagnation. What is this? What are we? Are we a relationship? Is this moving forward? They don't want you to be discontent and bored anymore. And they also feel like they missed the opportunity with the Four of Cups in reverse. So they want to work on that. They want to fix that. Okay, strong earth and air energy here. Six of Swords in reverse. You moved on from this person, but they want a second chance. Some of you could be a Pisces. They're unsure if you will come back to them, though, with the Six of Swords in reverse, but they're willing to shoot their shot. Yeah, Cancer energy here twice with the moon. Yeah, they're willing to shoot their shot for reconciliation, judgment, and the Three of Cups. They want to come back, okay? Some of you, they may have to leave an earth sign to come into you, to come to be with you. But for a lot of you, I feel like this is you. You pulled your energy back, Queen of Pentacles and the Eight of Cups. You pulled your energy back. You and this person may have argued a lot. If they were married, you argued because they were still married and you were tired of that. You were tired of them being stuck to the past with the Emperor and the Six of Cups. Some of you could be a Scorpio, Aries, Taurus. All right. You were tired of this dealing with them being married. Okay, and the conflicts that come with that. So, I mean, they could have been married to an air sign, okay, a very hostile air sign. Seven of Wands in reverse, though, they want to clear these blockages. Whatever was blocking you two before, they want to release that. Also, you may have blocked this person. So if you want this person back, if you want a new start with this individual with a Fool card here, you may want to unblock this person, okay. Yeah, someone's releasing a situation. They were stuck in something before. They weren't letting it go. They didn't want a big... Some of you, they have a child with someone, so their child could have... Either they have an older child who has an opinion, so they didn't want their child's opinion of them to change, or they may have... They didn't want to lose the stability of having a child in their life. But I feel like that's going to happen either way. Pluto and Mars and Tower energy, they just don't care. Okay? This person could have already went through that Tower. Okay, so let's look at your synastry together as a relationship. Let's see how you're showing up in the connection, Virgo. Astrologically wise, let's see how Virgo is showing up in their relationship with this person. What is Virgo's energy with this person astrologically? Lunar eclipse change. So lunar eclipse, I feel like you are the catalyst for change. The energy is like a dark energy. So I feel like you've pulled back from this person and it was to get... you got the lunar eclipse and you got the solar eclipse. So this definitely could be a twin flame union, but you pulled your energy back to get the masculine to change. Some of you could be dealing with the fire sign. Aries is here again, Leo, Sag. You wanted change, so you pulled your energy back. And as a result, you've changed this person. So you both have an effect on each other. You had an effect on this person. This person is coming up as the fire element. I didn't even get a chance to ask. Did you guys hear me ask what they were coming up as? No, they just jumped up out the deck. So they're definitely probably a fire sign. We definitely don't wait, okay, for people to call on us. We just put our answers out. We just put our bid in. So you could deal with good, see, can't even talk. Could be done with a Leo. You could be done with a Leo. So you have the sun here. Yeah. Could be done with a Sag. Very fiery person. This person wants you. Desire. Okay. They're coming up as the fire element. So they could be any of the fire signs, but they're definitely coming up as desire. You're coming up as change. So you're the actual catalyst for change by not doing anything. The moon doesn't do anything. Okay. So this is a very nice, relationship. I'm seeing trines to the moon energy. So you guys can have a lot of trines in your chart. Trines are actually good aspects to have in synastry. You may emotionally fulfill this person, and as a result of that, that it makes them desire you. Okay, there's a strong connection with your moon and this person's moon. So they like you might have your Mercury placement sitting next to their moon. So the way you speak nurtures them, makes them feel better, something like that. So you definitely, if you're interested in that type of thing to see how your charts match up, definitely holler at me for a synastry reading. But yeah, this is a very balanced connection. If it's a masculine energy that you're dealing with, if you're a feminine, this is very balanced because you're coming up as the moon and they're coming up as the masculine. Okay. So let's go ahead and get into the extended. We're going to clarify a few things for you and this person, okay? We'll also be pulling another card of advice from the Astrological Tarot deck to see what you guys are going to be working on with this person in January. But for the most part, I'm seeing this person wanting to fix things with you very strongly. They're regretting how they treated you. And you cut this person off, and as a result, it has changed them to me for the better, okay? So let's see what's going on in the extended. You can follow me over there, Virgo. Your link will be in the description. Let me know how you guys like this new type of reading. I've never done this reading before, but I like it, especially with the astrology cards being associated. So let me know how you like it, or if you don't, make sure you like the video, you share it, subscribe. It really helps out my channel, and I will see you guys for the extended, okay? Bye, Virgos.